My dear soldiers, I could not answer the call of duty to be the Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines without writing down my immense gratitude and deep appreciation for the tiring, selfless dedication that has become the hallmark of the Filipino soldier. Through the years as an officer on the field and in the front lines, and in the last 17 months as commanding general of the Philippine Army, I have been humbled by your sacrifice and commitment. You take on the wind and the rain, the sun and the heat, without complaint or respite, as you go about your perilous duty. You leave your family for days, even months on end. Secure the families in your assigned area of operation. You face threats and foes, be that the barrel of the gun or the wrath of a super typhoon, so that communities did not know fear or war. You are teacher, builder, engineer, farmer, forester, protector, defender, and most of all, a soldier. Some of us have given the ultimate sacrifice, and we remember them every day, not only for the bravery, but for the humanity. And the rest of us take heart and gain strength from their courage and faith in mission. We are better because of their sacrifice. We are stronger for their service. I have asked it often enough, as I visited your camp in the mountains or checked your newly assigned quarters, what you need to do a better job, or what else your family needs. Most of the time, you answer with a smile and say, "Okay na po ako, sir. Basta may naiabot sa misis. Basta meron para sa mga bata." Simple hopes indeed. And it has been my priority to fulfill those hopes and meet those basic needs. I write this letter of thanks to you, my dear soldiers, because it has not been said often enough. It has not been shown nearly enough. I'd like to say thank you from the bottom of my heart for doing a good job and to say forward march and fight on. Win the peace, secure the future. Father in service, Dodo.